Oh, hey, quick question for you. You ever just walk into a Dollar Tree and stumble upon their DVD section every so often that they have them and find just the wildest knockoff horror films imaginable? I will give you 5 seconds to think about it. I thought so. Because not too many people walk in the Dollar Tree looking for DVDs and Blu-rays. Not at all. No. Well, today, I shall introduce you to some examples of the amazing garbage you can find in these dollar stores, right? Oh. Ladies and gentlemen, I am the Hat Man. Welcome to Dollar Store Horror. And on today's episode of Dollar Store Horror, we have a truly graceful piece of garbage. The Selfie Man.
Yes, you heard that right. Selfie Man, the name is as ridiculous as it sounds. Originally titled Selfie from Hell, and it was originally released either online or in theaters on May 3rd or 4th, 2018, as release info isn't exactly clear on which date or whether it was rather released in theaters or online. I'd be willing to wager it was probably released online, as I have never heard of this movie back in 2018. Not at all. The movie is a feature-length adaptation of a 2015 short film called Selfie from Hell, and I'll tell you now that that short is so much better than this movie. And so the movie begins with our soon-to-be fake-out protagonist, Julia, who proposes the idea of selfies from hell. And the general idea is if you take 13 selfies, a shadow figure inches nearer and supposed to take out the trash on the 13th selfie. I don't exactly think it's made clear on how this works. Hey, maybe I'll give it a try.
Let me take a selfie.
And would you look at that? Nothing happened to me. Anyways, we see Julia, who is all of a sudden scared of selfies at the airport. Next thing you know, she is completely out cold in bed after taking a bunch of selfies. After her blonde friend, whose name I don't even remember in the movie, starts researching a site called the Black Room Onion and getting distorted texts from an unconscious Julia, she looks at chat logs on the dark web to find out what's going on. Then she has a conversation about the paranormal with her boyfriend, yada yada. It's not really that important to the plot. She eventually finds a way to get into Julia's account to find her part two blog of her show, and it reads like a if you see in this, I'm probably dead kind of video. Soon, Julia starts levitating off the bed, and the smartest decision in the movie is made. They took her to a hospital. So I didn't exactly mention it earlier, but when Blondie was looking at chat logs, she gave her info out to a bunch of strangers on the deep web. Terrible idea. As it turns out, the antagonist was obviously the one that got it, calls Blondie, and wants to know where she lives. Soon she wakes up in a literal red-tinted room thanks to being knocked out in person by her Tinder date. Our antagonist, once again for the audience and the people in the back, explains that the way for Selfie Man to kill you is by checking out all 13 selfies. Even though I'm pretty sure Julia was taken out by taking her own selfies. So after about 12 selfies, our antagonist is taken out via electrocution due to her boyfriend showing up out of nowhere. I don't know how he found out where she was. That's besides the point. They go and find out that the Black Room is operated from a phone, according to our antagonist's computer. They then go into a building where it should be to find a photo album, and I think I remember there was like a doctor talking to a pale guy. But of course, let's skip ahead a bit. The dumb blonde takes a 13th selfie and is taken out by the creature on the cover, who we only see for like less than 5 seconds in the entire movie, not counting the actual selfie pictures from the beginning. 'Cause that's just a dark shadow. So our movie ends with a false afterlife. Everything seems like it's back to normal until you realize it's an afterlife when Selfie Man appears via black eyes and all that and tortures everyone in there for eternity. Fun, fun, fun. This movie unfortunately has it all. Terrible effects, god-awful writing, irrational fear of technology, which ends up being laughable. And I think Selfie from Hell is a more appropriate title than Selfie Man, as our titular creature from the cover is only, again, only on screen for less than 5 seconds.
And you know, even though I only paid $1 for this movie, I still want my money back. This movie gets a 1 out of 10 from me, man. It's a movie that commits the unforgivable sin of being boring. This is the Hat Man, and this has been Dollar Store Horror.